Also, so, you know, Dwayne Bacon is out with the injury. Mm-hmm. And in his stead, Devonte Graham has moved into the starting position as a two guard, with Rozier really as the one, but they're both playing kind of a combo guard. And there hasn't really been a fall off in his overall production. So do you guys think that Graham should stay installed as a starter? Should we try Malik Monk as a starter? Should Bacon get that starting role back when he comes back? How do we feel about that?
Honestly, I give Bacon one more shot. We don't know if the injury has been affecting the shooting percentages or not. Let him get healthy and put him on a short leash. And then at that point, try Monk. But I'm also concerned Monk starting. I like Monk better against second units. And I like him in that microwave role, the Vinnie Johnson type role, coming off the bench. Heat up. You see if he's working. If he's not, come sit down. Come sit down, Malik. But I like what JB has been doing with Rozier and Graham. Rozier plays so much better with Graham on the floor. Mm-hmm. It allows him to get off the ball. It's like he's a small two guard, which kind of concerns me, but leave that one alone. But and I like that he's been staggering their minutes. And so one of them is always on the floor at all times. I love it. JB is just a survivor.
Well, first off, I want to point out that Bacon was actually available to play last night.
That's right.
Versus the Knicks. Right, yeah. He was available to play. Yeah, he was available.
He was listed out there.
He was up. Yeah. He was a DNP CD. Ooh. Yeah. But I think that was because like of the type of injury, because it's a knee. So I think when I looked at the pregame, I think JB said, hey, we're just going to go with it for the game. Now, he said before the game, he said Nick will play. And even though Nick had a good game last night, I think Nick got something on the org. Okay, we'll talk about that. I think Nick got a dirty secret, and he's like, hey.
I know what you did last summer.
Yeah, right. Exactly. But, no, Bacon was a DNP CD, and I think it's because it's a knee. It's a knee issue, so, like, maybe he just doesn't want to bring it back too soon. With that being said, this is a good problem for JB to have. But I'm going to go against the grain here. And when Dwayne Bacon is ready to come back and start, I think he should come off the bench with Devonte Graham while Malik Monk starts. Because because Bacon plays best with Devonte Graham.
That's true. Yeah.
And I think now with Graham, we're asking a lot of Graham, because you just said that Terry plays better with Graham on the court as well.
Right? Yeah.
So Graham is going to be logging starter minutes while coming off the bench. Mm-hmm. But I think what happens, I think you have to put Monk in that starting role, have Bacon coming off the bench,
well,
and have
him chewed up defensively.
So we saw some of this last season, late in games, where JB went to the Kemba Walker, Tony Parker backcourt, and it worked. How many times did we get Tony Parker bail us out because there was somebody else to take the pressure off of Kemba? And everyone was like, I don't understand why he's running such a small backcourt. But it worked because you have two ball handlers in the backcourt, cuts down on turnovers, and then, you know.
Create for others.
Exactly. So that's working. So that's why I would say it's not such a bad idea to start Devonte Graham, mainly because one of the Hornets' biggest issues is we get off to these like bad early starts. So you let them get a little bit of chemistry going, and then you can be more competitive in the beginning, and then you bring Monk and Bacon in. However, having said that, I can tell Devonte, I'm not going to say he doesn't feel comfortable starting, but it takes him a while to get it.
I noticed that
he wasn't really that productive as a starter in the opening minutes of those games. And then once the game kind of came to him, then he just starts lighting it up.
Yeah.
See, like, with that being said, if we go Devonte as a starter, we need to get a reliable third point guard in this roster. Because I'm not sold on the other Martin brother being a third point guard.
Yet.
He has he even played maybe one or two games?
He's played
one game with
him. I'm not sure if he's played at all. But I know he actually just got assigned to the
Swarm.
To the Swarm. But he's appeared in three games, but he's played like he's averaging like 8 minutes. So I'm guessing just garbage time.
Garbage time. Yeah. So if we were to do that, we need to get a solid third point guard option.
Yeah.
At least to spell him some time, like 8-10 minutes a game, to actually lead the. I don't need you to score. Be a passer, play some defense, and that's it.